Now, let's talk of something different. Let's talk of watered stocks. Watered stocks. When are stocks said to be watered? Huwag yung sasabihin, sir, pag binaha, watered yun. Okay? Alright. So, stocks are said to be watered when they are issued. But the corporation does not get the full fair value of the shares. Shares are said to be watered when they are issued, but for which the corporation does not get the full fair value. All right, to illustrate. Let us say we are stockholders of a corporation. Okay, and our corporation has been engaged in construction. Yung construction of houses, warehouses, buildings. In short, what they refer to as vertical construction. And let us say our corporation has been doing very well in the past many, many years. But let us say, due to the present economic conditions for the past 2 years, we have not had any new contract. We are still doing a lot of things, but we are just finishing old contracts. All right, so in short, in one meeting of the board, the president mentioned that the corporation has a problem, that soon there'll be nothing to do because we have had no new contracts for the past 2 years. All right. And, well, we could justify the absence of new contracts by the present economic conditions. All right, so in short, one of the other directors said, why don't we go into land development or horizontal construction? Why don't we bid for government projects, especially that when economy is bad, government comes out with a lot of new projects. Okay? All right. Upon hearing that suggestion of that director, the others commented, sabi nila, how do we expect to get contracts for public works when we are all aware that all biddings for public works are rigged? Alright. So, sabi naman ni director, the one who made the proposal, sabi niya, walang problema. Best friend ko, yung girlfriend ni mayor. Alright. Now, I'm not talking of any particular mayor. This is a generic mayor. I just want to be, not because we are in Manila or whatever. No, it's a generic mayor. Okay. Alright. So, upon hearing that from the director who made the proposal, sabi sa kanya, oh, sige, subukan mo. I tried talking to her. See how she could help us get contracts for public works. Alright. So, with the blessing of the board, that director talked to the girlfriend of the mayor. Not the wife, girlfriend. Because usually the girlfriend is more powerful than the wife. Okay? All right. So, the director talked to the girlfriend of the mayor. Sabi niya, Mary, pwede ka bang maging chairman of the board of our corporation? All right. Sabi naman ni Mary, how could I be chairman of your corporation when I don't even own a share? Di ba, matagal ko nang gustong bumili ng shares. Ayaw niya naman akong bentahan. Alright, so in short, she's interested. Right? So sabi ni Direk, sige, we will qualify you to be chairman. Okay, so the director met with the other directors and said, oh, payag na si Mary. She's agreeable to become our chairman of the board. So let's qualify her. In short, they discussed, oh, ilan bang shares ang ibibigay natin kay Mary? Right, so in short, let's say they came out with a decision to give her 1 million shares. So as to qualify her as chairman of the board. So decided na ng board yon. Sabi, sekretaryo, you prepare a stock certificate in the name of Mary for 1 million shares. At pirmahan muna. Alright, so sekretaryo naman, following instructions from the president, prepared a stock certificate in the name of Mary for 1 million shares. Pinirmahan niya, the president signed also, and then the certificate was given to the director talking to Mary. Kaya lang sabi ni Direk, oh, bigyan mo rin ako ng kopya ng ano, ng articles. Bigyan mo rin ako ng kopya ng latest audited financial statements. Alright, so in short, they're placed in one envelope. The following day, kinausap ni Direk si Mary. Sabi niya, oh, na-qualify ka na namin. You can now be our chairman of the board. Oh, ito na yung stock certificate mo. Ayan, oh, 1 million shares. Alright, oh, ito, kopya ng articles. Para makita mo, ang par value is 1 peso per share. Okay? Oh, ito pa. Copy of the audited financial statements so that you could determine the book value. Book value is higher than par value. Alright. So, when Mary examined the documents, sabi niya, mahal naman itong shares na ito, 1 million. Sabi niya, hindi, iyo yan. Libre na yan to qualify you. Sabi ni Mary, no. I cannot accept this for free. If you want, I'll pay. And then she insisted, she issued a check. Yan, 600,000 pesos. Alright. Sabi ni Direk, hindi na kailangan, bayad na yan, okay na yan. But then Mary was insistent. Sabi niya, oh yan, you accept, or else I don't accept. Mabait naman si Mary. She didn't take advantage of the 1 million shares. She paid 600,000 pesos for those shares. But then those shares are worth 1 million pesos. So though she had paid for those shares, still, they are considered as watered stocks. Why? Because the corporation did not get the full fair value. What's the full fair value? If par value is 1 million pesos, I'm sorry, 1 peso, or total of 1 million pesos, and book value is higher based on the balance sheet, okay, then the shares must be worth at least 1 million pesos. But Mary paid only 600,000 pesos for those shares. So despite her payment, as the corporation did not get the full fair value, those shares are considered watered stocks. Okay? And what is the consequence, or what are the consequences of the issuance of watered stocks? Okay. As far as Mary is concerned, the shares were worth 1 million pesos, at least 1 million pesos. She paid 600,000 pesos. For now, there may be no problem. But if the time would come that the corporation would have an unpaid creditor whose claim against the corporation could not be satisfied from the assets of the corporation, Mary could be obliged to pay the difference. Okay? If there would be any unpaid creditor whose claims against the corporation could not be satisfied from the assets of the corporation, okay, that creditor or those creditors could claim against Mary for the difference between the value that she paid and the fair value of the shares she received. So we can say that Mary could be obliged to pay the difference of 400,000 pesos if the corporation won't be able to pay from its assets the claims of its creditors. creditor or creditors. All right, so that's one consequence. The person who received the watered stocks could be obliged to pay the difference. What else? As the law provides, the director or directors who did not object to the issuance of the watered stocks shall be solidarily liable with the person who received the watered stocks. The director or directors who did not object to the issuance of the watered stocks shall be solidarily liable with the person who received those stocks. Okay? All right, and to illustrate that, let us say there were five directors. Okay, five directors. All right, so in short, they had this meeting to discuss on how to qualify Mary. Okay, so in short, the one who proposed voted to issue watered stocks to Mary. So, and he was joined by two others. So in short, three out of five already agreed to give Mary the watered stocks. So no question, those three are solidarily liable with Mary. And yung fourth one, when they were already deliberating or voting on the issuance of water stocks, yung pang-apat, sabi niya, oh, taklo na kayo, carried na yan. Abstain na ako, ha? Alright. Kasi alam niyang consequence. Kaya sabi niya, oh, carried na, taklo na kayo. Kaya ako abstain. Alright, sabi niya, oh sige, okay. Make that of record. Director number 4, abstain. Alright. He is also solidarily liable. Because he did not object. Okay? Oh, yung fifth one. When he was observing the discussion, may kinakabahan na siya. Sabi niya, naku, pag hindi ako bumoto, to issue watered stocks, sasama ang loob ng mga kasama ko. In short, while the others were voting on the issuance of watered stocks, yung panglima, because of the pressure that he was experiencing, he had a stroke. Okay? Then, before he was able to say either yes or no, na-stroke, he collapsed, and he had to be brought to the ICU of the nearest hospital. Fortunately, he survived. Alright. Question. Is he liable? Yes. He did not vote against. Sabi mo, na-stroke na. Liability, meron pang liability? Yes. Kaya, there is a way out. Upon learning that water stocks were issued, if he does not agree, he should file with the corporate secretary his written objection. And if he doesn't, he becomes also solidarily liable with the others. Get it? Alright, so those are about watered stocks. Okay? Watered stocks are valid, except that those who received and those directors who did not object to their issuance become solidarily liable to unpaid creditors whose total claims cannot be satisfied from the present assets of the corporation. And their liability is to the extent of the difference. The difference between the full fair value and the value that was paid. Okay? All right.